فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون
أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, sometimes the abnormal may happen by the leave and the permission and the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of these abnormal, supernatural things that happened, which the Quran and the Sunnah shared with us, was the speaking of infants in the cradle. That you have children or infant, to be accurate, actually speaking, and this is abnormal. And today, inshallah, Nu'arrij, let's talk about some of these incidents. ورد في صحيح الإمام البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says only three spoke in the cradle in that particular hadith. But if you add two more for sure, so the total is five. So the total number we have in the Quran and the Sunnah who spoke in the cradle as infants are five. Number one, Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. Number two, the infant who spoke to save the worshipper Juraij when the women accused him of adultery, Ghulam Juraij. And number three, the infant who was suckling and his mother made two supplications for him and he did not like them. Number four, Ghulam al-Ukhdud, the little boy or the infant again who said to his mother, Ya anti ala al haq, my mother, you are on the truth. When the king basically told his people whether you leave Islam and accept me being your Lord, commit shirk, or whether you have to throw yourselves into this fire. So the baby of this woman spoke as well, that is four. And a similar situation, the hairdresser of the daughter of the Pharaoh. So those are five. There is one that is disagreed upon amongst the scholars of hadith, which is Shahid Yusuf. When the woman grabbed Yusuf, Imra'atul Aziz grabbed Yusuf from his shirt, and وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا, Ibn Abbas mentioned that it was an infant. But عَلَىٰ أَصَحِ الْأَقْوَالِ, it was not one. So number six is disagreed upon. Now, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make this supernatural thing happen? If you look into the five incidents, you will find two of them to save someone who is oppressed, to save someone from injustice. Juraij, he did not commit adultery. He's a righteous person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the infant speak to save him. The second one with Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wassalam is to save his mother from the accusations and the allegations of Bani Israel because they accused her of adultery. وَبِكُفْرِهِمْ وَقَوْلِهِمْ عَلَى مَرْيَمَ بُهْتَانًا عَظِيمًا. And because of their disbelief and their uttering of lies against Maryam. We know that Bani Israel at first, they said that Isa alayhi salam was born from adultery. So Prophet Isa alayhi salam, as an infant, he spoke in the cradle to protect his mother. This is number one. But number two, to establish the fact that he is Abdullah. Because the first words that came out of his mouth, Inni Abdullah, I am the servant of Allah. So those two, to save someone from injustice. The other two is to grant firmness, Tathbeet al-Mu'min. Imagine a mother, especially a mother, seeing her infants or her children, in the case of the hairdresser of the Pharaoh, and in the case of the women of Al-Ukhdud, the trench, thrown in fire in front of them. Al-Umm bi that, the mother in particular, a mother cannot handle this. ولذلك يا إخوة, سبحان الله, حديث عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, at one time he saw from a distance, a woman looking at her baby infant, after a battlefield, and she finally found him. So she grabbed him and she started breastfeeding him. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at his companions and he said, أَتَظُنُّونَ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْمَرْأَةِ طارحة ولدها في النار. Do you think this mother can throw her baby in hell? They said no way, impossible. حينها قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لله أرحم بعبده من هذه المرأة بولدها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more merciful to his servant than this mother to her baby. The mother was about to compromise her tawheed. She loves her baby. ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الصلاة sometimes he would say كما في البخاري we have a lot of space here inshallah تفضلوا. Okay. في صحيح البخاري الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says sometimes I would want to lead the salah and I want to prolong the salah, prolong my recitation make a long recitation, and as soon as I hear a baby crying I shorten it. Why? Because of the mother. خوفا على الأم. وسئلت يا إخوة الأم العربية, the Arabic woman was asked أي أطفالك أحب إليك, who do you love most of your children. قالت, she said المريض حتى يشفى والغريب حتى يعود والصغير حتى يكبر. The little one until he grows old, and the sick until he cures, until he heals, and the one who's traveling outside until he comes back home. Especially in the case of the hairdresser of the Pharaoh, the daughter of the Pharaoh. She had four children, based on Hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas, رضي الله عنهما, في مسند أحمد, وفي صحيح ابن حبان, four children. Each one of them was thrown into that cow made out of basically copper, which the Pharaoh commanded for it to be heated up. They were thrown one after another. She was holding fast. She was keeping her iman until the last one, until the baby, until the infant. And she's about to compromise, to say, my Lord is the Pharaoh. And subhanallah, look, المؤمن إذا كان مؤمن, the believer when he is a believer, Allah grant him tathbeet even through supernatural things, and that infant speaks. So those are the four cases. So two of them to save people, righteous, pious people from injustice, from ظلم, وقع عليهم مريم, مريم هذه عفيفة, ومريم ابنة عمران التي أحصنت فرجها. You accuse her of adultery, Isa speaks to save her. Juraij, Rajul Abid, used to worship Allah 24/7. And the other two, the other set of two, is simply to grant tathbeet, firmness to the believers. Here is the one that I want to share with you, the rest of my khutbah today, which a lot of people do not talk about. We probably know about the hairdresser of the daughter of the Pharaoh. We know about the story of the trench. We know about Juraij. And we know about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. But this one, very few of us know about it. And this is the third one, the story mentioned in Hadith Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu. What is the story? Umman kanat turdi'u waladaha. A mother was breastfeeding her baby. The baby is being suckled. As she was breastfeeding her baby, a very nice, good-looking man passing by, riding a very nice, prestigious car, horse. Then the mother immediately looked and admired the man so much, and she said, Allahumma ij'al ibni mithlah. Oh Allah, make my son like him. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, by the way, did this to his companions. The little infant was suckling. He left it and he did like this. Allahumma la taj'alni mithlah. Oh Allah, do not make me like him. I don't want to be like this man. The mother said to her baby, halqa. What's wrong with this baby? First of all, she's amazed that he speaks. And second, he is opposing her. He's not agreeing with her. Then after a while, a jariya, a little girl, being chased by men. They are throwing rocks at her. Ya zaniya, you are a fornicator. Ya sariqa, you are a thief. Ya kada, ya kada. وهي تقول, and she says, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Then the mother makes the dua, اللهم لا تجعل ابني مثله. اللهم لا تجعل ابني مثلها. Oh Allah, do not make my son like this little girl. The little infant again left and he said, اللهم اجعلني مثلها. Oh Allah, make me like this little girl. The mother said, حلقا. يعني, may you have a problem with your حلق, so you do not speak. What's wrong with you? And then the little infant started explaining himself. He said, as for this man, who is good looking, prestigious, he is probably half the dunya, وَلَكِنَّهُ جَبَّارٌ, but he's an oppressor. He's a liar. And I don't want to be like him. Yeah, he has the dunya, but I don't want to be like him. And as for this little girl, she's innocent. She is not an adulterer. She's not a thief. And I want to be like her. Not, again, the scholars of hadith explained, they said, he did not want to be beaten up like her or chased like her. Nobody likes this. No, but he wants to be free of sins like her. She's innocent. Brothers and sisters in Islam, that fifth incident of infants speaking in the cradle addresses a very important issue that we need to pay attention to. موازين الخلق موازين الناس وموازين رب الناس في النظر إلى العباد. The way we see people and the way Allah sees us, or the way that Allah sees you and the way that you like people to see you. The point I'm trying to make, I don't want to confuse you, that at this time, at this era, at this age, these are days of deception. There are a lot of deceptions. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, والحديث في مسند أحمد وسنن ابن ماجه, سيكون سنوات خداعات. Time will come when will be deceiving years ahead of you. Look at this. يصدق فيها الكاذب. The liar will be believed. ويكذب فيها الصادق. And the one who speaks the truth will be belied. ويخون فيها الأمين. And the trustworthy will be mistrusted, will be accused of treason. ويؤتمن فيها الخائن. And the one who really misbehaving and simply betraying his trust will be entrusted. Here it is. And we see this before our eyes. Wallahi, I see it before our eyes. وينطق فيها الرويبضة. And someone called the الرويبضة will speak out. قالوا وما الرويبضة يا رسول الله. Who's the الرويبضة يا رسول الله? Huh? It's an Arabic word. The Arabs did not understand. Who's the الرويبضة يا رسول الله? He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, الرجل التافه يتحدث في أمر العام. A foolish one will be taking the lead of the public. He's in charge. The point that I want to drive across today, brothers and sisters in Islam, and it is the most important point that I'm concerned about, Don't be focused on what people think about you. Don't. Just concern yourself how Allah sees you. أنت من في نظر الله؟ الناس هذا انسى. انسى. Forget them. Forget them. Because people will make their own call. Listen. في حديث سهل بن سعد الساعدي أبي العباس رضي الله عنه والحديث في البخاري. Just for you to see this. مر رجل, it's a very similar حديث to حديث the infant. Very similar, سبحان الله. مر رجل برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. A man passed by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and someone was sitting next to him. Again, good looking. And يا إخوة, don't think that if you dressed well, if you're rich, is bad. You're really missing the point. You're missing the point. That's not the point. You see, riches by itself is not good. Poverty by itself is not good. The only thing that is good by itself is taqwa. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Listen, three individuals, لا ينظر الله إليهم يوم القيامة ولا يزكيهم ولهم عذاب أليم. Three types of people, Allah will not have mercy on them in the day of resurrection. One of them is what? هذا هو الشاهد, the witness. Look, 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 look. عائل مستكبر. Someone who is poor, but what? عنده استكبار, arrogance. فما تقوليش because you're poor then you're good in the sight of Allah. لا, sometimes you find a poor who is despicable in the sight of Allah because he doesn't have the taqwa either. Likewise, if you're rich and you have the taqwa, alhamdulillah. If you're poor and have the taqwa, alhamdulillah. But poverty and riches are not measurement by themselves. They have to be combined with what? الإيمان والتقوى. فسهل says, a man passed by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and next to him is a companion. Again, a good looking, ما شاء الله, riding a nice horse. And he asked him the question, ما تقول في هذا? What do you say about this man? قال يا رسول الله. He said, O Messenger of Allah, هذا والله, this one والله, from the noble of the Muslims. This is, he looks, هذا حري. If he speaks, the people will listen to him. Yeah. If he proposes to a woman, his proposal will be accepted. Marriage proposal, يعني. And if he intercedes, if he goes and intercedes, معلش يا عم محمد الرجل ده, in behalf of somebody, عشان أكشر, خلاص. His intercession will be what? الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم did not say a thing. Oh, he did not say a thing. After a while, another Muslim passing by. ما هو يا إخوة, this is really the, this is the cornerstone here is who are you in the sight of Allah? But this Muslim now is إيه? يعني he is struggling, even walking. غلبان يعني. شكله غلبان. ما تقول في هذا? What do you say about? قال يا رسول الله هذا والله, this is from فقراء المسلمين, from the poor of the Muslims. هذا حري. If he speaks, I don't think people will listen to him. And if he intercedes, who's going to accept his intercession? And if he goes and proposes to a woman in marriage, I don't think he'll ever going to get married. Here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is drawing the line. This is poverty and what? And riches here. قال هذا, this one, خير من ملء الأرض من هذا. This one in the sight of Allah is much better than earth filled with the first one. In the sight of who? In the sight of me and you? In the sight of who? That's where you should worry about. Who are you on the side of Allah? Careless about who are you on the side of people. Careless about what people say about you. Like this little girl, he's a thief, she's a thief, she's a fornicator. She is. And the whole community is chasing her. But yet she says what? حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah is all sufficient for me. He will protect me. Allah is all sufficient. And that little infant wishes to be like her. He wants to be like her. يا إخوة والله حديث أقرأه. It breaks you. It breaks you. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث أصله في صحيح الإمام مسلم. أصل الحديث في مسلم. حديث أبي هريرة also. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم رب أشعث أغبر ذو مرطين. شوف هذه, لو أقسم على الله لأبره. It may be a servant of Allah أشعث. يعني أشعث basically أشعث is somebody whose hair is what is not in is not combed because he cannot even buy what the oil. لا الكوم ممكن, ممكن كل واحد يعمل كده بس ما عندوش حتى الايه الزيت. He doesn't have the oil. أشعث أغبر ذو مرطين يعني wearing. شوف هذه, لو أقسم على الله لأبره. Imagine this, someone who says what, some say, يا الله, I swear on you that you're going to give me this. شوف, can you imagine that you take an oath on Allah? We have one hadith in Sunan al-Tirmidhi that a righteous man did this and Allah punished him. A righteous one. Hadith in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. And I'll go back to that story. Two brothers. One of them is righteous. The other one is wishy-washy. One week he's on, he prays like a lot of Muslims now. You know, one week he's in the masjid and another week disappears. What happened to the brother? And mashallah, he shows up again. Keep showing up, alhamdulillah. فسبحانallah, the righteous one used to live in the top of the mountain. And he used to come sometimes and visit his brother downstairs. فهي arrived, he found him sinning. He saw him sinning. What did he say? What did he say? تعرفون الحديث؟ قال والله لا يغفر الله لك. أقسم على الله. He took an oath on Allah. He said, by Allah, Allah will never forgive you. You know what Allah said? Allah revealed to the Prophet at the time. This story happened in Bani Israel. Allah revealed to the Prophet at the time and he said to him, من هذا الذي يتألى علي? Who is this? Who's taking an oath on me? Huh? أخبره, let him know that I have forgiven the sins of his brothers and all his righteous deeds are in vain. He needs to start working over. غفرت له وأحبطت عمله. Why? 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 What happened? Even though we know that he is righteous from the hadith. Why? He did it out of ujb. He was admiring himself and being judgmental to people that try to help a sinner to come back to Allah. Don't tell them that Allah is not going to forgive you. لماذا تحجر رحمة الله سبحانه وتعالى? Why do you confine the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى? Why? Like the man who killed 99 souls and he goes to the first one. Do I have a chance? He said to him, no. ليه? Why? قال سبحانه وتعالى ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. My mercy encompasses everything, everybody. ولذلك في الحديث اللي هو the Bedouin who urinated in the masjid, there is a piece, an extension of this hadith that a lot of us are not aware of it. When the companions chased him and given him a hard time, and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shown him a lot of mercy, he made this dua and he said, Allahumma arhamni wa muhammada wa la tarham ma'ana ahada. Oh Allah, have mercy on me and Muhammad alone, no one else. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to him, laqad hajjarta wasi'a. You're making the mercy of Allah just on two. Even though, I go back to my man here, even though he was righteous and pious and his brother was a sinner, but when he took an oath on Allah, he did it out of what? Out of arrogance, out of pride, and also being judgmental, and he locked the gates of mercy in front of his brother. I go back to Hadith Muslim. رب أشعث أغبر ذو مرطيني ذو مرطيني لو أقسم على الله لأبره. If he takes an oath on Allah, Allah will fulfill his oath. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, I said the origin of this hadith is Sahih Muslim, but the wording in Tirmidhi, ومنهم البراء بن مالك. He named one of the companions البراء ابن مالك. Imagine البراء ابن مالك, if you go to him and please take an oath on Allah. In a battle after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, during the reign of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu an, a battle called Tustar في فارس in Burja. It was a tough battle. The Muslims had a very hard time because they had fortified fortress and high walls and very difficult to invade. For the Muslims came to him, Ya Bara, Ya Bara, يعني please help us out, help us out, we need help. After a lot of pressure he agreed and he said, Allahumma inni uqsimu alayk, O Allah, I take an oath on you, an turyana aktafahum, that we see their backs, meaning that we conquer. Here is the peace that is so amazing. Wa anta tawaffani shahida. When something like this, ya ikhwa, happens at the hands of a no messenger, we call it karama. We don't call it a miracle. But we do have mu'jiza al-Nabi or karama lil-wali. You see, the Prophet is supposed to disclose his mu'jiza, his miracle, because this is what establishes his prophethood, his messengership. You know, I have to show my miracle as a messenger in order to prove that, listen, I'm being supported and aided by a divine force. La ilaha illahu. But the karama should be kept in secret. That's why you should not disclose the karama. Al-wali, the true wali, doesn't disclose his karama. That's why al-bara made this dua. Because this is a karama. And he was certain that Allah will answer his dua. Now what will happen? The Muslims are going to leave the tawakkul on Allah. الهو وما النصر إلا من عند الله العزيز الحكيم وما النصر إلا من عند الله إن الله عزيز الحكيم. And they will start looking at who? البراء. No, I don't want to be. Likewise, even though يا إخوة قصة the companions of the cave, if you read the end of it, even though it's Israeliyat, we don't believe it, we don't believe it. When they discovered who they are, they actually went in prostration and they asked to die, because they did not want to be fitna for people. For this is why al-Bara made the dua. Al-Shahid, or the important thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, we live at a very trying time. People have the freedom to say what they need to say, what they want to say. My message to you and to myself today, care less about what they say. I'm not asking you to promote it. No, don't concern yourself with it. Actually, if you're able to minimize this, to actually remove this, it's much better. يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he was doing his i'tikaf in the masjid in Ramadan, and what happened? Safiya رضي الله عنها, his wife, came to see him. So, because he's doing i'tikaf, he did not want to leave the masjid, so he's talking to her from the entrance of the masjid, and Safiya is standing by the door. Of course, they were wearing niqab. فتو أنصاري passing by, فدي ايه, they kind of ايه, went faster, يعني ايه, let's give the Prophet free time, يعني. So come back here. Come back here. إنها صفية. This is صفية, my wife. زوجتي. يا رسول الله, يعني, we're never going to think, إني خشيت, I'm afraid that شيطان will cast bad thoughts about me to you, in your heart. فتكفره, and then you leave Islam. سوء الظن بالنبي كفر. If you second guess Rasulullah, you disbelieve. If you have bad thoughts about Rasulullah, of course it's from shaitan, and you entertain them, you disbelieve. سوء الظن بالنبي كفر, هكذا قال العلماء. Again, I'm quoting this author. Why? Even though I'm telling you not to care less about what people say, but at the same time, if you're able to stop it, to protect it, to protect yourself, do it. But if you try and try and try, it's not working, who cares? What matters is who you are in the sight of your Lord. Because Allah will judge you. Allah will judge you. I conclude my message with this beautiful hadith. Musnad Ahmad. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم at one time he asked Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه to bring him a siwak. فعبدالله ibn Mas'ud climbed the tree of al-Araq. That's the name of the tree. فعبدالله ibn Mas'ud was known to be a very thin, extremely thin. ولذلك روي عنه يا إخوة, he would prefer not to fast. Because he want to do other acts of worship. Because he's very weak. And sometimes, if he walks and there is a strong wind, he actually have to hold down because the wind could what? Could move him. So when he went up to the Araq tree, the tree, for the wind moved his garment. For the companions who were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw his shin. Very thin shin. فذي looked at one of يعني طبيعة البشر يعني. فنظر إليهم. He looked at him صلى الله عليه وسلم. أتعجبون من دقة قدم ابن معبد؟ Are you amazed how thin are the shin of ابن معبد؟ والله والذي نفسي بيده. By the one in whose soul my in whose hand my soul is, لهما أثقل في الميزان من جبل أحد. They are heavier in the scale than the mountain of Uhud. Who cares? Worry about your Lord, brothers and sisters in Islam. Worry about Allah. Please Allah. Work for Allah. Do what you do for Allah. Don't worry about the people. Wallahi, Allah can change the hearts of people in a second, for you or against you. When Imam al-Bukhari entered his town, Bukhara, for the first time, you know how many people met him? 300,000 people. Imagine, met him. To the extent that they wanted to carry his horse and him on the back. And when the fitna of Khalq al-Quran came, he was one of the scholars who stood. He did not disclose his opinion. Not like Imam Ahmad. Imam Ahmad stood. No! Al-Quran kalam Allah. Minhu bada'a bila kayfiyatin qawla. Wa unzila. Arraf. Imam Ahmad, some scholars, they stood in the middle because there was punishment. There was a punishment. Al-Mu'tazila were in control of the Muslim world. He said a word that could be this or that. When he came back to visit his town, four people came to meet him, his family members. Wallahi, worry about Allah. Work for Allah. Love Allah. Do things for Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in this dunya, if not for sure the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, just a quick update regarding what's happening with Dar al-Tawheed. Alhamdulillah, last week or the week before, I think was the 9th of February, we closed on the property in East Hamden by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We gave in $250,000. The overwhelming majority of this money came out of state, not from Denver, if you're wondering what's going on. Out of state. A lot of the brothers, they believed in the mission. I know them. And alhamdulillah, they helped out. Some of them goodly loans. Some of them actually given donations. By May 9th, we have to give another $250,000. And this is the only hurdle that we have. After that, every year, 120, which is doable. For 7 years, we managed to get, alhamdulillah, a good contract, Sharia compliant, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Insha'Allah, we started an initiative that if each one can just recruit 5 brothers to come up with 1,000 each, so each one will be in charge of $5,000. If we gather 50 brothers and sisters, inshallah, the 250 will be there. We actually started that initiative. So far, we, alhamdulillah, up to $110,000. And we received $60,000 in money. I just deposited the check before coming here, from here, from the local community. After the salah, inshallah, if you feel like you, we're not asking you to give the 5,000, we're asking you to raise it. If you can raise it all, alhamdulillah, if you cannot afford it. Basically, you go to community members, family members, if you can help us. Because by May 9th, we have to give that money. Because really, he has a lien on the land. That's where, you know, we're sleepless sometimes. The owner has a lien on the land. And I don't want him to go and foreclose in our land, which will not happen, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. We have plan A, plan B, plan 3, bi-idhnillahi. Wallahi ya ikhwa, subhanallah, this project has been going in a very interesting way. 2 days ago, we got in touch with a non-profit, non-Muslim organization. Non-Muslim, a non-profit, who has taken the responsibility of giving $60,000 to renovate the community center and make it ready. So as we speak right now, they are working, you know, preparing the place. Subhanallah, from their own. And in return, all they want a sign saying that they renovated. It's a non-profit. And they wanted me to come and meet with their, and simply attend. No compromises, I promise you. We don't compromise. It's a project. It's for the youth, for the women. And it's open, inshallah, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. By March 21st, we have our opening, official opening, but we're going to try to hold Salah sooner than this. If not, then in Masjid Umar, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we're working for the sake of Allah. We're working for Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This project is for the youth and the women. We prepared it. This is the vision that I spoke to you about three years ago in Masjid Abu Bakr in the fundraisings, and I came back to town to deliver this. Uqsim billah, I swear by Allah, I do not need to be in this town. I am giving up a lot to be here, but I am coming because I want to complete that vision. I want to deliver. I'll deliver it, and it's yours. It's your community. Salaamu alaikum. Wallahi, I have a lot of things to take care of. Alhamdulillah, Allahumma laka alhamd. I'm not nagin. Ana yani ahmadu ilaykum rabbi. But I promised. And you know, a lot of you giving money because I stood out there. This is Imam, and he's not. Now, if I leave like this without completing this vision, now we need you to be out there to help us. We need you to help us complete this vision. For the ummah, for the youth, for our children. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma arina alhaqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'a wa arina albatila batilan warzuqna ijtinaba. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min alfitan ma zahara minha wa ma batan. Allahumma ansur alislam wa izza almuslimin wa adilla alshirka walmushrikin wa ahlik a'da' ad-din ya rabb alalamin. Allahumma ahdi banatana wa awladana wa shabab almuslimin ya rabb alalamin. Allahumma ihfazhum بالإسلام قائمين وبالإسلام قاعدين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.